should I report to? Okay. Okay, well, will I be on the same floor? Okay, well, no. Getting my job back is exactly what the doctor ordered. Well, the only thing better than maybe getting my job back is maybe getting a little raise. Hello? Hello?
Hey, Ma.
Hey. How was school today?
Great. Even better was this. Bam!
What's this?
It's from the principal. You know, you gotta be enrolled early if you wanna play sports, but they're waving it so I could play.
Oh, they must really like you.
No, they like the nets I've been popping.
Except I didn't say you could play again this season.
Well, you didn't say that I couldn't, so I just took it as I could.
You know what our rules are.
Yeah, I know. Grades before sports. But if I'm good at sports, who needs grades?
You need grades.
Nah, you need grades.
I've got skills and grades. Did you talk to your father about it?
What for? He's not even here. I'm not thinking about him, he's not thinking about me.
Junior, get back here. Get back here. Now, just because your father... Hey, I'm talking to you. Just because your father isn't here doesn't give you permission to be disrespectful.
Well, does the fact that he left you for a white woman give me permission?
No, come on, let's not... How do you know she's white?
I mean, her name is Brittany. How many black women do you know with the name Brittany?
Okay, you know what? Color aside, your father chose to be with somebody else, and if she makes him happy, then so be it.
How long you been practicing that little speech?
A few weeks. You didn't fall for it, did you?
Nope.
Neither did I.
Well, look, I mean, I'll call him, but I'm not asking him. It's just like he didn't ask if it was all right for him to leave you for...
Hey!
For a homewrecker. Who's white. Allegedly. Oh, that's my coach.
Oh, wait a minute. Who said you can invite someone over here?
It's just my coach.
Wait a minute. He's your potential coach, and I'm gonna tell him exactly like I told you. He needs to speak to your father. Now, he may be a cheating, lying scoundrel, but he's still your father.
Now, that sounds more like you,
Mom. It felt better, too.
Hey.
What are you doing?
Who is that?
It's my coach. Oh, my new coach.
You didn't tell me he looked like that?
What does how he look like have to do with anything?
It has everything to look with everything. Boy, you better get out of here. Don't you.
What is wrong?
Open that door.
What is wrong with you? You just want me to leave him standing at the door, knocking?
Yes!
For how long? Ma, you're being ridiculous.
I know I am, but what are you?
Ma!
Now you can open the door. Boy, open that door.
What up, coach?
Hey, a woman just answered the door and slammed it in my face. Everything all right?
Yeah, man, this is my crazy
aunt. Hi.
Mom, coach, coach, mom.
This is your mother.
Yes, who did you think I was?
My grandmama.
So, coach, what can I do for you?
It's my first year coaching down at the school, so I thought it'd be a good idea to meet the parents of all my players.
Star players.
Potential players.
But you probably want me to talk to his father.
Right? Oh, no. I can handle it.
Mom, but you just said that I...
You see, his father recently relocated to Chicago. He switched jobs.
Switched a lot of other things, too.
Okay. Yeah, I grew up in Chicago. Love playing in the snow.
Apparently so does my dad. Allegedly.
His father and I are
getting
separated.
A divorce.
Separated.
I see.
Okay, so I will give it some thought and let you know.
Okay. It was nice meeting you, Mrs.
Call me Samantha.
You can call me Keith.
Keith.
Samantha.
Keith.
Samantha.
Okay, now that everybody's got everybody's name down. Don't you got some more parents you gotta go meet or something?
Yeah. I'll see you at practice.
Keith, Samantha. What was that all about?
Boy, I am grown. If I want to say that man's name 1,000 times, I can. Keith.
Mom, is something wrong with you?
Hi, baby.
Hey, Mama.
How you doing? Ooh, look at you. You just look so good. It's so good to see you. Have you done something to your hair?
No.
Have you lost some weight?
No.
Well, you just look so angular. I like it.
Mm-hmm. Mama, what are you up to?
Nothing. Do I have to be up to something to compliment my own daughter?
Mm-hmm.
You were on my mind, and I just thought I would stop by and see how you doing. I've been thinking about you a lot lately. You and Sylvester. So how is Sylvester?
He's fine. He's at basketball practice. You just missed him.
No, Sylvester, your husband.
Oh, him.
Have you talked to him lately?
No, should I have?
Well, after all, he is still your husband.
Mama, would you please stop saying that? Sylvester has moved on with his life, and it's time I accept it and move on with mine.
Well, what if that wasn't the case?
What if what wasn't the case?
That he's moved on. Aren't you gonna answer the door?
Why? Who is it?
I don't know. I don't live here.
Oh.
Hey, I didn't know anyone would be at home, so I used my key. I hope you don't mind.
Sylvester, what a surprise! Well, I know you two have a lot of catching up to do, so I'm gonna go. You two always look so good together. Like those white people in the picture frames at the Walmart. Sometimes I don't even take them pictures out of the frame. Those white people look so happy.
Mama.
It's so good seeing you again, Sylvester.
It's always good seeing you, Olivia. Always good seeing you.
Thank you, Sylvester.
Thank you so much. The place looks good. And now you, you look even better. Hey, look, I realize I probably should have handled things a little better. I mean, a lot better, but just so much traveling going on and just stuff.
Sylvester, what do you want?
I miss my son, and I miss you.
Oh.
I just had to come in for an overnight trip to tie up some loose ends at the office, and I started thinking, why not?
Why not what?
Well, I was thinking, why not stop by and see them both? I mean, you know, the craziest thing happened. Now, you're not going to believe this. My assistant calls me, and she informs me that there's a convention in town, and every hotel within a 50-mile radius is booked. What are the odds? That's crazy, huh? Crazy. So I started thinking, you know, why not?
Oh, hell no,
oh,
that's why.
Come on. Sam, come on. Come on. It's just one night. We don't even have to sleep in the same bed. You can sleep on the couch. I'm joking. Come on, Sam, look. Did you think I would ask if I hadn't exhausted every other option? I mean, this is hard on everybody. I'm sorry, look, I'm just trying to make our relationship work a little better. For our son, you hate me, yes.
Yes.
But love our son.
That almost sounded sincere.
Because it was. If it's unbearable, then I promise you I will never ask again. Someone's at the door.
I'm not deaf, I hear it.
You want me to get it?
No, you don't live here anymore.
Ooh, girl, these folks done got on my nerve with their welfare, Medicare, Obamacare. It's just too much. Whew.
Hello, cat.
Samantha, tell me I'm hearing things. So I'm not hearing things? So, Satan is actually in the room. Oh, hell to no.
Hey.
What are you doing?
No, what are you doing and what is he
I'm in
doing?
Town for a little while.
Just what? I'm not talking to you, adulterer.
He doesn't have anywhere
to go. Oh, I know a few places he can go. Wait.
Look, can I go to the restroom?
Well, yeah, there's a fire hydrant at the corner, you dog.
Just go ahead.
You are not thinking about letting him stay here.
Cat, he is here on business. He doesn't have anywhere to go.
Sure he does. It's called a hotel. Motel Holiday Inn. And that fool's been acting up, so you let them take his ass in.
Listen, there's a convention in town. There's no place else for him to stay. And plus, it would do Sylvester Jr. some good to spend some time with his father.
What kind of woman would let a man stay in her apartment that just left her for another woman? I mean, shoot, you know, he might go to sleep. Oh, but I guarantee he would never wake up. And I mean never.
Get over here.
Look,
I don't like it either, but it's complicated. And plus, you wouldn't even understand.
And why wouldn't I?
Because you've never been married.
Is there anything to eat in the kitchen?
There's some rat food under the sink.
There's some leftover chicken in the refrigerator.
But she only has dog meat left. But she might have some pork though. You know, the other white meat.
Other white meat, got it.
You know what? I'm just gonna let y'all get back to your little complicated marriage that I wouldn't understand. Cause I ain't ever been married.
Cap, I didn't mean that, girl.
You didn't mean that, girl. I hope you know what you're doing. And you know what, Sam? I done had 15 men to your one. Check that. Good night.
Cat, come on.
What the hell is Cat talking about? There's all kinds of white meat left on this chicken. All kinds of white meat. All kinds.